So far, we've discussed how we can use instrumental variables analysis to learn about causality. But I've been pretty loose with what I mean by a causal effect or learning about causality. Now remember, there's actually a different causal effect for each unit in the population. And our typical goal is to learn the average of all of those unit-level causal effects. That's the average treatment effect. So what exactly can we learn with instrumental variables analysis? Well, unfortunately, the answer is pretty complicated and depends on some other technical assumptions you have to make beyond the three core assumptions we need for instrumental variables analysis: relevance, exclusion, and exogeneity. Now, under some other assumptions, instrumental variables can be very powerful and can let us learn the entire distribution of unit-level causal effects. So not only do we get the mean, the average effect, but we also get some idea of the variation in these effects. Do some people have really large unit-level causal effects while others have very small unit-level causal effects? We can learn some of that under other assumptions. Now, I'm going to focus on just one specific effect that is widely known and widely discussed, called the local average treatment effect. This is just a single number, like the average treatment effect, but unlike the average treatment effect, it's going to be a weighted average of unit-level causal effects. So the question here is, what are the weights? Another way of putting that is, what units are included in the average? Some units may get a higher weight than others. Some units might be dropped completely. So what exactly is going on? Well, to answer that, it's going to depend on precisely the setting we're looking at, so we'll look at that in another module.